Hello, Mayday family. How are you doing today? For those of you that are new to my channel, my name's May. I'm a licensed counselor with a YouTube channel. A lot of you are going back to school. A lot of people are going back to school, whether that's middle school, high school, college, whether you're doing your bachelor's or getting your associate's degree. It's time, right? We haven't been able to be in school or go back to school in what feels normal to us in a very long time because of what we've been experiencing in 2020. But now a lot of people are at a point where they're going back to school, and a lot of districts are also at a point where they're going back to school earlier than they usually would. So apparently they are doing things a little bit differently than what they did before, and a lot of kids are going back to school very early August. What used to happen is kids used to get, not even kids, but even individuals that are in college working on their associates or their bachelors or whatever they may be working on, used to get a full 3 months of summer vacation. And now that's not the case for a lot of districts in the United States. A lot of districts are choosing to go back to school early as August, the first week of August, as opposed to the last week of August or the month after. And so that's a huge deal. I mean, it's exciting to feel like we're gonna be able to go back to school in a way that feels familiar to us, in a way that feels like the norm to us. But what comes with that is also a lot of anxiety. A lot of us feel anxiety when it comes to going back to school, especially now, because it's been so long since we've been able to go back to school in what feels normal to us, or in the way that feels the most normal to us, that we might be experiencing even more anxiety than before. So today in this video, I wanted us to talk about three tricks and three things that we could do to help lessen the anxiety that we feel, especially the third one. The third one is super interesting, and I came across it by accident, and I think you guys will really love trying it out because it's so simple and easy to do. So if you want to know what those three things are, make sure to stick around for the rest of this video. The first thing that I would suggest as far as trying to mitigate and manage the anxiety that you might be feeling during this very important time of getting ready to go back to school is meditation. I know you've probably heard the word once or twice or thrice, three times, but it's really, really helpful. And the little change that I want to put to this, the little spin that I want to put to this is we don't have to meditate for 15, 30 minutes at a time. What I typically do in the mornings when I'm getting ready to go out or get ready for my day is I'll do a simple 5 minute guided meditation. And I want it to be a guided meditation because sometimes I just get bored. If I'm trying to do a meditation that's longer than 5 minutes, my mind starts going crazy. I start thinking about this, that, what I have to do for the day, and then it kind of defeats the purpose, or at least it feels like it defeats the purpose. So what I do is I keep it short. I keep it at 5 minutes in the mornings when I wake up, and make sure that those 5 minutes is time that I can use for me and just for me alone. So I do 5 minutes of guided meditation. I make sure that it's guided meditation because I want someone that's talking me through those 5 minutes, and that helps me pay attention to my here and now and focus on my meditation. And it also helps me build up to the point where eventually, hopefully, I am able to do 5 minutes of meditation without having to be guided through it. But to start out, I make sure that it's 5 minutes of guided meditation. So how do I go about doing this? I will type into YouTube or Google, mainly YouTube, and I will type in 5 minute guided meditation, and I will pick one of the ones that comes up that might look like an interesting one to do, or a good one to do, or one that I'm familiar with that I already like doing, and I make sure to get those 5 minutes in there no matter what, in the morning before my day, because as the day goes on, it keeps you more energized, starts you off in a positive mindset, and it gives you time for you to relax and really calm any of the anxieties that you might have from starting your day or from starting school. The second trick that I have for you as far as helping calm your anxiety, especially now that school is starting, and for all of you, you might be experiencing that at this point in time, is using songs. When I was a kid, I used to use this a lot to calm my anxiety. When I was younger, I would get anxious about different things. I would sometimes, for example, I'd be in school and I would get anxious when school ended because I didn't know if I was supposed to take the bus or if my mom would be able to come get me or if someone would be able to come get me from school. So I'd get a little bit anxious because I would just think about, how am I supposed to get home today? And I know that sounds weird, like, oh, you were abused as a child. I wasn't. I was just an anxious child. And I'm still an anxious grown-up, but I've learned how to manage that a lot better, right? So, you know, little things like that would make me anxious as a kid. Or if I have a test or if I'm starting school, I would get really anxious, especially starting school, especially when I first got into high school, 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade, 12th grade, I was anxious almost every day. So one of the things that I learned to do is to use songs. I picked one of my favorite songs, which I still use till today. When I get super anxious, I'll start singing that song over and over again, and that tends to calm me down. It tends to calm my anxiety down. So I make sure to have a song that takes me to a happy space. Maybe it's your favorite song, or it's a song that you really love that you feel good when you sing, and you notice that you are getting anxious. What I want you to do is to immediately start singing that song to yourself in your mind or out loud. Either way, just keep singing the song and singing the song and singing the song, and within a minute or two, you'll notice that your anxiety has really calmed, it's come down, and you're able to navigate and move forward. It really, really, really does work. And if you're able to attach that song to a happy memory, that's even better, because then you're singing the song while thinking about this memory that makes you happy, or this time that made you happy, and you're able to calm yourself down from the anxiety that you might be feeling. So that's the second tip that I have. The third tip that I have, which is the simplest tip that I ran into by sheer accident, and some of you might have heard of it, but I hadn't heard of it at all. I did it because it was by accident, and this is something that I really want to share with you because it's the simplest one. What I use for the third tip is lip balm. So I make sure that it's specifically this type of circular lip balm. I'm trying to cover up the logo here, but it's this circular lip balm. It's a circle, and the shape is very important because if it's a circle, it rolls onto your lips a lot smoother, and it feels different. You know what I'm saying? Like, so I use this one specifically. It comes kind of like this circular lip balm right here, and you kind of open it up and then it's half the circle, right? And I think they sell these at Walgreens and just about any store. And I will just take this and I will I will rub this on my lips back and forth while my eyes are closed, and I'll just take a deep breath while rubbing this on my lips back and forth, and it feels so good, and it works wonders in reducing my anxiety. I know it's the weirdest thing. I know that might sound weird, but it works, y'all. Like, try it and let me know. But for me, it works so well. And I think it's just because there's so many, and your lips is one of the most sensitive areas of your body. And so it's pretty intense as far as like how much the neurons that are in your lips that are there to feel, right? And so by running this on my lips smoothly back and forth and gently, and just kind of getting lost in that feeling and closing my eyes and taking a deep breath while I'm doing it, literally reduces my anxiety so much, y'all. And I want you to try that because it is so good. It helps me, especially when I'm feeling anxious. So make sure to buy this specific kind of lip balm, because I'm not sure if any other type would work. I haven't really tried it with any other type. I've tried it with one other type actually, and it wasn't the same. So make sure it's this circular type of lip balm and just kind of like rub it, and just the feeling, it's almost like getting a massage. It's so weird. So that's the third tip that I have for helping reduce your anxiety, especially now that school is about to start. But I know that you guys will do so great. You're awesome. And again, if you are experiencing or you experience any anxieties, use any one of these three tips to kind of calm those anxieties down. Any of these three would really work well for anxiety reduction, whether that's because you're going back to school and you're feeling really anxious right now, or because of something else. So I want you to try any of these three to see which ones you like the best, and use it whenever you're feeling anxious for any particular reason. Again, thank you guys for joining me. Go ahead and smash that like button for me and for the YouTube algorithm, and hit that subscribe button so you know anytime a video comes out, especially videos such as this one. And if there's anything that you want to see, any recommendations that you have, any questions that you have, definitely leave it in the comment below, and I'll be more than happy to make those videos for you as well. Thank you for joining me today. I look forward to seeing you in the next video, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.